How do we know the structure of DNA? Not much was known about genetic material until 1864, when Johann Miccha was the first to isolate nucleic acid. He extracted white blood cells' nuclei and found they contained an acidic component in proteins. He called this compound nucleine, which was later called nucleic acid. However, it was still unknown if it was involved in the inheritance of traits. In 1949, Erwin Chargaff discovered several properties of DNA, called Chargaff's rules. The first rule was that in DNA, the amount of base pairs match up. That is, the number of adenine units equals the number of thymine units, and the number of guanine units equals the number of cytosine units. This hinted at the base pair makeup of DNA. The second rule was that the relative amounts of guanine, cytosine, adenine, and thymine vary between species. This hinted that DNA could be the genetic material. Chargaff did not explicitly connect his findings to any conclusion about the structure of DNA, but it was essential for later scientists in determining the structure. Next, Rosalind Franklin provided an important clue for the structure of DNA with an X-ray photo of DNA. According to the picture, DNA had an X shape. Franklin's X-ray diffraction image strongly implied a helical structure for DNA. After seeing Franklin's photograph of DNA and their own research, James Watson and Francis Crick were convinced of the double helix shape of DNA and published their thesis in Nature. Their helix model satisfied all previous experiments about DNA, such as Chargaff's rules and Franklin's photograph. This discovery won them the Nobel Prize in 1962. Today, we know a great deal about the structure of DNA. It is made of a long chain of nucleotides consisting of adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine bases. As we learned, adenine is paired with thymine, and guanine is paired with cytosine. Thymine and cytosine are called purine bases, as they consist of one phenyl ring, while adenine and guanine are called pyrimidines, as they consist of two rings. This pairing of purines and pyrimidines ensures the two strands of DNA stay the same distance apart. DNA is made of two strands, and it carries inheritance information. In its chemical structure, two strands are twisted along each other, with the bases held together with hydrogen bonds. Phosphate and 5-carbon sugar molecules, called 2-deoxyribose, form the phosphate-deoxyribose backbone. The sugars are joined together with the phosphate groups by phosphodiester bonds. Our understanding of the structure of DNA has grown immeasurably since Miccha first isolated it in 1864. Through the efforts of numerous scientists and researchers, such as Chargaff, Franklin, Watson, and Crick, we now know significantly more about the compounds so essential to our lives here on Earth.